she played the TV character that Australia loved to hate in the 1980s. Viewers couldn't get enough of Rowena Wallace as Pat the Rat on the drama Sons and Daughters. But the stardom quickly faded and Rowena found herself pawning her Logies just to pay for food. Now, you've heard the stories, but now in her most revealing interview yet, she sat down with Craig Bennett to talk about reaching rock bottom.
It was a career that spanned 50 years and 5 Logies.
But I loved every minute of it. And I've missed it. I've really missed it.
English-born Rowena Wallace found herself centre stage on Australian screens. From Pat the Rat in Sons and Daughters to Prisoner, number 96, and a role in Cop Shop, which she remembers more for making cups of tea for George Malaby than actually acting, revealing it almost got her fired.
And then I did an interview with someone very like you. I said, well, all I do is make cups of tea for George Malaby and I'm getting sick of it. I want something to get my teeth into. And they said, well, if you feel like that, you can leave the show.
Tell me what that level of fame was like, Rowena, because you were known all around the world and you had become a TV icon.
I mean, it was fantastic, but I got very tired of it all. And I actually got to the stage where I didn't want to go out shopping. I didn't want to go up the road to the supermarket because I would get Pat the Rat, Pat the Rat, Pat the Rat all the time. And I sort of thought, I think I'm really turning into Pat the Rat. It's like playing an instrument. You're the instrument and you're playing it all the time. And I just got really tired of all of that. And so I left and I really thought that when I left that I'd get a chance at maybe a film or do some theatre or whatever. In retrospect, which is terrific, isn't it? I think I should have taken a good holiday and then gone back to it.
And it was the momentous decision to move away from acting that Rowena regrets the most.
I started grieving for the life that I'd had. I wasn't motivated anymore. I just thought, oh, well, I'm going to die in one thingy. What the hell?
And depression set in.
And depression set in.
Living in rural Victoria in a small town called Wonthaggi, Rowena found herself at her lowest ebb, scrounging for spare coins around her house and in the pockets of her jackets just to put food on the table.
I mean, I have learned a lot. Learned a lot about what it's like to be a pensioner, and it's bloody awful. It really is hard.
You've really struggled, haven't you?
Yeah, I have, yeah. But so have millions of others, elderly people and not so elderly people. It's hard work. Yeah, it's hard work. Like so many of them who have pets, and I've got 2 gorgeous dogs, I would make sure they're fed before me.
Broke, sick and in pain, the bright lights of showbiz had long faded. And Rowena found herself in a darkness she never expected.
Probably the last couple of years have been the worst because I began to suicide ideation. And that's not healthy when you start thinking, what is the point of all of this? I'm just going to get sicker and more pain, and then I won't be able to walk because I'll be in a wheelchair and I see a path ahead of me that is so full of awful things, I just think, oh crikey, let's just finish it now. Find the dogs a really good home and finish it. You get lost in the depression.
So Rowena, what gets you out of your deep depression?
The dogs. Because if I sit down and have a good cry, bless them. They just jump all over me, they lick me, they know.
But her cries haven't fallen on deaf ears, and it's clear that Rowena still has many fans across the country. A fan knows of your plight and is setting up a GoFundMe page in a bid to help you move nearer to where there might be work opportunities.
You are kidding me.
I would never kid you.
That's absolutely amazing. That really is amazing.
So buck up, Rowena.
Sorry, don't know what to say. Yes, it would be absolutely wonderful.
And as you heard, Rowena Wallace's friends have set up this GoFundMe page. If you'd like to help out, you can go to GoFundMe.com and search Rowena Wallace Needs Your Help. An excellent story brought to you by Craig Bennett again. As well, Lifeline can always be contacted on 131114. It's a 24-hour number for help at any time.